The Philippine National Telecommunications Commission has granted Advanced Media Broadcasting System, owned by former Senator Manny Villar, the authority to use two television frequencies previously assigned to ABS-CBN Broadcasting Network. Documents from the NTC show Villar's firm was given a provisional authority to install, operate, and maintain a digital TV broadcasting system in Metro Manila using Channel 16. The regulator also issued a temporary permit last January 6th, allowing the media firm to test broadcast using the Channel 2 frequency. The frequencies were returned to government after House lawmakers allied with President Duterte rejected the network's franchise bid. ABS-CBN is the parent firm of this news channel.
The president of COP26, Alok Sharma, tells governments around the world to honor the promises they made during last year's climate talks. He says countries should do more to tackle climate change, especially the group of 20 nations. The COP26 deal asked governments to set tougher targets by next year for cutting climate warming emissions.
So it is now time to honor our promises, to build on the trust and consensus generated in Glasgow and deliver with integrity. And that requires action on both a domestic and international level. We need every country to play its part and honor the promises that they've made, but we must also work together.
Last week's volcanic eruption and tsunami in Tonga have been taking a huge toll on the mental health of its residents and aid workers. Here's a full story.
Tonga is struggling to deal with both ash and the psychological fallout of last week's volcanic eruption and tsunami. The Red Cross said it was providing not only tents, food, water, and toilets to 173 households on Tonga's main island, but also comfort. Aid workers and residents said families have stopped children playing outside due to the ash. Vice President of Tonga Red Cross, Drew Javier, said they were looking to send a boat with drinking water to the outer islands as soon as possible.
Some has been evacuated to Nuku'alofa have been relocated by the government and have been relocated with their families, but there are others who have nothing but don't want to leave the islands, which is quite sad in from our perspective.
He also said the psychological impact of waves rushing through and destroying villages will affect people for some time. John and Marion Tukufu are still assessing the damage to the beach resort they own. They say the rush to find higher ground was a traumatic shock.
Really, nobody knew that there was a wave coming. So, you know, in every household that was on the road, like, we just shouted out, tsunami, tsunami, you know, get to higher ground. We just thank God that, like, you know, he led us. I mean, you know, even though the siren didn't work, but, you know, sent us as a siren for our village, you know, to inform people on the road. They were even just standing in the corner stores, just buying and, you know, we thank God we're still here.
Tonga's government said drinking water was the priority in the next couple of weeks, and a national emergency team had already distributed 60,000 litres of water to residents.
In other news, U.S. President Joe Biden holds an 80-minute video call with European leaders to discuss the Ukraine crisis. Biden said it was a good meeting and there was total unanimity in what they wanted to achieve, which is to deter further Russian aggression against Ukraine. Some of the actions they're preparing are massive consequences and severe economic costs on Moscow, as well as security reinforcements on NATO's eastern flank. On the part of the U.S. military, it says 8,500 troops are already on standby.
Secretary Austin has placed a range of units in the United States on a heightened preparedness to deploy, which increases our readiness to provide forces if NATO should activate the NRF or if other situations develop. But again, no mission has been assigned to these troops. No deployment orders have been sent to them. What the secretary has ordered them to do is to be ready to go, in some cases, on a much shorter tether than what they had before.